The following film has been modified from its original version. It has been formatted to fit the screen. To run in the time allotted. And edited for content. Warning. The following program contains mature subject matter, coarse language, drug references, and discussion of a sexually suggestive nature. Viewer and parental discretion is strongly advised. Enjoy the continuity errors. Insert your own gun sound. 3, 2, 1, gun sound. Enjoy the film.
Good evening, ladies. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. You're watching a recording, live recording version of Excuse Me. My name is Rodrigo Poole, and I'm writer, producer, and director of this piece, co-produced by Xena Black and Zinfira Stage. And foul fucking language. At this point, I'd like you to silence all your cell phones, pagers, and small children. I'm glad there's no small children here because this is not a children's fucking show. Furthermore, if you'd like to come back again, well, I guess that announcement doesn't include 4 people watching the video right now. Hey! Hey there!
It's okay. I'll wait. You can hit the bong. It's fine. This is how you actually have to watch the show. Completely fucked up. That's right. Just wait until the acid hits. Second act's gonna be fucking amazing.
So that's it for the announcements. I'm incredibly proud of everybody in this production. Thank you for watching this. And if you like this show, my name is Rodrigo Poole. If you don't, my name is Tommy Wiseau, and this is The Room.
Started moving these boxes to the back.
What are those?
Those are the reason I got no sleep last night.
Oh, Russian kid!
Some of them are pretty damn heavy.
What are these?
Beer. Fresh, locally brewed beer.
Costumes.
I know.
What's in the box?
The goddamn box!
It says Hawk Juice.
Hawk Juice!
A terrible name, huh? And now all our specials are half price due to no particular reason other than to push clientele to buy Hawk Juice, which we've unfortunately become completely overstocked with.
Who's gonna wanna drink Hawk Juice?
No clue. But your salaries depend on it!
What?
That's right! corporate is cutting funding on all unnecessary items on inventory and replacing them with hawk juice.
Donkey poop?
Yeah, donkey poop is right. Apparently hawk juice is awesome.
But how does that affect me?
Ask this twat.
Hey, Mr. Kennedy?
That would be me, and you are?
Hi, Oh, I'm sorry. Hold on a second.
What are you doing?
I'm just looking for something. I gotta find
What's going on?
I just gotta find this thing real quick.
What are you looking for?
Just give me a minute! Just give me that minute! Oh, phew! Boy, am I glad I found that. I'd be in a lot of trouble if I forgot that. Oh, I'm sorry. Hi, I'm Jonathan from corporate. I'm here to oversee your inventory the first day's sale.
Okay! Jesus, Hernando Christ! You are literally the most awkward human being I've ever met. We just opened. I literally have not set a foot inside the store. I'm sorry, sir. Get a seat at one of those tables over there, and I'll be right with you.
Yes, sir.
And drop the sir business, man. Calling me sir.
He's that tiny white girl.
That tiny white girl is corporate. Hawk juice, as I was telling... You know what? Guy, come on up here.
Yep, Mr. D.
Well remembered.
Hey, what time is it?
9:30.
A.M.?
A.M.
Friday?
All day long.
Thanks.
You're welcome. This right here, whose name escapes me at the moment.
That's not a pretty little white
guy. It's Jonathan. Hey.
Right. John is going to explain to us why our salaries now depend on hawk juice. Break a leg.
Thanks, Mr. D.
Not encouraging you. I actually do hope you cripple yourself.
That seems a bit excessive. Well, hello, my name is Jonathan, and let us start off by making things a little bit more clear. It's not that your salaries depend on it, but studies shown in our New York facility have proven
donkey
that...
Donkey poop.
Donkey poop?
We know why you're selling these mass quantities of crap juice.
Well, that's good, because we're selling... Hey, wait a minute.
Blindcore.
Blindcore is our exclusive partner for electronics and material goods, such
donkey?
As...
Donkey... Poop.
Donkey poop? Who says donkey poop around here? Donkey poop? Is that a thing?
A little bird told us they were doing tests down in Seahawk Bay out in Joyceville. Test subjects began to react horribly to their new beverages.
Well, I assure you there's absolutely nothing wrong with our beverages. We are 100% certified by the FDA.
Donkey poop.
A. Seriously, donkey poop. Who says that? Donkey poop? Is that a thing?
Then tell us why they basically shut down the entire town after they relocated their testing facilities.
And reports of human cannibals are basically berated around town.
Yet no one said a word.
Or peep.
Or meow.
Or meow.
Yeah. Cats have voices too, you know.
Yeah, I guess so. Or meow.
And they're also incredibly flammable.
Why do you know that information?
Why or how? But do you know the real reason we never heard about this?
Not enough celebrity death.
Yes, that and...
Blindcore! That went well.
Hey, I didn't get your name. Actually, either one of you.
Anyway,
I didn't get your name.
You, John, please, go back to the main floor and I'll be right with you sometime. Not now.
Yeah, but I was just trying to get
you, John.
So sorry, pardon me. There's right there. Thank you, sorry.
Hey, man, what's up?
Why are you wearing that?
I am Batman.
Okay, stop. Seriously, stop.
Hi, Batman.
What?
Fuck!
I mean...
Hey!
Good citizens, it's nice.
Merry Christmas, everyone!
Why are you doing this?
I don't know. I panicked. What was I supposed to say? What would you have said?
No, not that. You need to stop.
What? What are you talking about?
You know exactly what I'm talking about. You need to stop.
Good morning. Welcome to this and that. How can I help you?
Yes. I'll have the senior deluxe platter.
I'm sorry, sir. Those dishes are for seniors only.
Oh, right. Okay. I know this. My grandfather's on his way, and he asked me to order for him.
Oh. I apologize, sir.
As you should. You are very... rude. And don't you sir me. Do you know who I am?
Bat?
I am the Bat.
I'm sorry. My friend here, he's an idiot. Can you come back in a few minutes?
I will do that.
Dude, what did you do that for?
I mean, I don't want to spit eating my food. They're not gonna spit in our food.
Side order of flat.
Coming up.
Absolutely they will, and if you continue to act like a jackass, then why do you keep ordering from the senior menu?
Hey, I like the food. It's good for my colon. Cheap, easy to swallow. They got fish, for God's sake. Who wouldn't?
Are you serious?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah?
No.
Okay. Well, now we're gonna wait forever, thanks to you.
What do you mean?
Well, every time the waitress comes, and you're not ready to order, and you ask her to come back, they take 9 fucking years to come back.
Well, maybe she wouldn't have to come back if you wouldn't order from the goddamn senior section.
Hey, I like the food. It was on the regular menu. It's on sale, and it's good for me.
Of course it's on sale. It's a fucking restaurant. Everything on the menu is on sale.
I meant discount.
Yeah, for seniors!
Oh, God. Okay, fine. I'll compromise, because we are friends. And that's what friends do. And friends do things for each other. Like I'm about to do now for you.
Yeah, whatever.
Welcome to Silver Awesome. We are awesome. Could I interest you in our specials or something to drink?
Awesome. Could I maybe get an awesome soda?
You got an awesome buddy. And for you, man.
Could I have some water?
Well, sure thing.
And can I just have the water? I don't know why, but every time I ask for water, these people insist on stubbing a green fruit in my drink.
Stubbing?
It's true. Every time I ask for water, they have the insufferable need to, I don't know, spice it up by dropping a floating lime at the bottom of my drink. What's he even supposed to do there?
Dearie, it's tad flavor, and I don't think you're using the word stubbing correctly.
Listen, if I wanted flavor, I wouldn't ask for water, would I?
Are you ready to order?
We just got here, sweetheart.
And for you, sir.
What do you recommend?
Well, our specials are half price due to no particular reason other than to push clientele to buy a certain product of which we unfortunately have become overstocked with.
And this is?
Beer, my good sir. Freshly, locally brewed beer.
No way, that's pretty awesome.
Does it give you cancer?
What?
Can it give you cancer? Seems to me it's a completely logical question to ask about beer.
No, I don't believe it gives you cancer.
Is that a fact or an assumption?
Well, I'm pretty sure it's a fact.
I don't know. You don't sound so sure to me.
I'm not.
Well, what is it? Are you sure not?
Neither.
So it does give you cancer. I knew it. See, this bitch is trying to give me cancer.
Could you give us a moment, please?
I will do that.
Thank you. So this little tiny squiggly shape.
Yeah, little and tiny. It's got to be pretty small, huh?
It is. It's there on the side. What is that called?
Show me. It's the numeral symbol.
Oh, I didn't know those were still around, like in old phones, you know?
Yeah, what about it?
Well, the little tiny number text symbol thingy says that it's 50 cents for additional toppings on a burger.
Yeah, I like bacon and cheese.
What if I took out the things that would originally be in the burger, and I instead asked for bacon.
Man.
No, think about it. Look, it says here that burgers come with side order of fries, lettuce, tomatoes, onions, pickles, and choice of condiments.
So?
Fuck onions, man!
Keep your voice down!
Oh. Fuck onions, man.
Thank you.
And tomatoes.
What's wrong with tomatoes?
Hey, everybody, look at me. I don't know if I'm a fruit or a vegetable.
Well, isn't it both?
I don't know. But I don't want any bisexual food in my burger.
Bisexual.
And while we're at it, pickles, too.
Why pickles?
Because they look like green penises.
I just like them.
They look like green
every
penises.
Every time you open your mouth,
green
a little bit more.
Penises.
Are you guys ready to order?
Can you just give us
a I am ready to order.
Fine. Order away. Order. Submit your request.
Fine. I will.
Okay, when will it be?
I'll have the senior deluxe platter.
Motherfucker!
I'm sorry, sir. Is that for you or your grandfather?
Oh, yeah, right. I was lying about my grandfather. It's for me.
I'm sorry, sir, but as I've told you, those dishes are for seniors only.
Well, what's the big deal? No. Why can't you just serve me the goddamn meal? What's so fucking special about being old? Oh, just because you were around when all the Beatles were still alive does not give you the goddamn right to purchase select forbidden meals.
I'm getting the manager.
Goddamn it.
Man, can you believe that bitch?
Eh, just go.
No way, man. I might be able to get a free meal out of this.
You know, this is just like you.
How can it not be me if I am me?
This is the kind of nonsense is what I'm talking about. This is why I called you down here, and I knew you would find a way to embarrass me.
How what? Embarrass You? I'm the one wearing the Batman costume.
Exactly. You walk in here wearing a Batman costume.
Yeah.
You order from the senior section.
Yeah.
Knowing goddamn well they're not gonna serve you because you're not a goddamn senior.
What? 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 Where the fuck is all this static coming from?
It comes from you, you being a jack-off in a Batman costume. Just go.
Well, at least I'm not a pretentious asshole.
Pretentious?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure nurses don't wear expensive polo shirts under their scrubs!
I'm not a nurse! I'm not wearing a polo shirt or scrubs! I'm not involved in the medical field at all! Where do you get this crap from? Do you even know what I do?
So what was all that then?
When?
Just now.
Then?
Yes, that.
You tell me, Mr. Awesome!
Don't talk to me using that tone of that voice.
Idiot.
Oh, I get it!
Yeah,
let me ask you something.
What?
How well do you handle rejection?
Oh, great, brilliant. Social place slightly crowded enough so I won't make a scene, but guess what? You don't get a break up with me.
Why the hell not?
Because I'm dumping your ass first.
You can't dump me, I just dumped you.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you asked how I took rejection.
I was being nice about it.
Too nice. Always too nice. Too nice. I got the hint,
nice.
I broke up with you first.
Too nice, that was too nice? Well, fuck you, I like being nice. Hey, when did you break up with me?
Just now.
When?
Yes, sir.
Just now?
Okay, I hereby pronounce broken up. So yeah, just now we're officially through, Kevin.
Can't be serious.
What do you want? Confetti? I'm marching about it. Everyone, we just broke up.
See, I knew you'd do this.
Look who's talking, you two-faced baboon. That's
baboon?
That's the type of monkey I would expect a primitive like you to know what it is.
You did it. You finally did it. I'm hurt. Yeah, those are my feelings you're walking all over. Are you serious?
Hey, Jeopardy, you can stop asking questions.
When are we going to sit down and talk about this like adults?
And what, hopefully come to the agreement we should give this another chance and prove exactly what, Kevin?
Oh, I don't know, maybe I jumped the gun?
Get a grip. If you're going to break up with someone, don't pussy out the last minute.
I'm not pussying out.
Okay,
I just
so we're officially broken off.
Stop saying
why?
That.
Why? It's true.
Just like that?
It's like that.
I don't appreciate your tone.
I don't appreciate your fat face and all your crap.
So the shotgun's finally come out, eh?
Yeah, you want to talk about what happened, fine, we'll talk about what happened.
First off, calm the fuck down.
Ever tell a woman to calm down?
I'm sorry. I just want to make it perfectly clear that what happened to Joyceville was not my fault.
Oh, it wasn't.
No, it wasn't. Those test subjects were supposed to be sleeping, you know that.
They weren't. They ate each other. People eating each other.
It's crazy. There's no chemicals that would react in such a way.
Yes, there were. Yes, there bloody were. You ignored my advice.
What advice?
You know what I submitted to HQ 3 days before the test on the
3 days?
Substance.
3 days? It takes way longer than 3 days to run these tests.
And how many drooling idiots does it take to bring down an
not
entire town?
Not my fault.
Not all of it, but it definitely smells
you
like
can't
you.
Can't possibly pin this all on me.
I just did. I said no.
Have you guys decided what y'all want?
No.
Okay.
I'll
give it some more time. Oh, these people.
Any orders?
No!
Man, how could this happen?
I know, these people, man!
Oh, Corporate Kid and Batman ain't getting anything either.
How do you like the place so far?
So bright, could be better.
So what's with all this blind core business?
What do you mean?
How do you two know so much?
I mean...
Well, we have a friend that worked in Joyceville.
Have?
Whatever.
So what happened to him, her?
Well, he worked as an intern for the Joy of Joyceville.
Oh, Jack and Jill,
1013. No, Jack and Sheila. This is after Jill mysteriously quits the show.
I heard she jumped off a window. Or was it the roof? I don't know. What is this?
Well, anyway, we haven't heard from him since the military shut down the town.
I heard about that. Seahawk Bay was completely cut off.
I got concerned, so I started looking into Blind Corps.
Well, there ain't nothing pretty about it.
What do you mean?
Well, for starters, they don't only do soda pop and beer.
What else do they do?
Chemical testing for the bioweapons industry.
Chemical testing?
Yeah, evil shit, too. Word is around the campfire, these guys have been testing a new kind of bacteria that strengthens their tissue.
They were experimenting on human test subjects.
You mean the Find the Flavor event?
What's that?
LifeCore sponsored this event. They invited people to come down to the boardwalk and try their new beverages.
You can't be serious.
Yeah, my cousin went to it. He said it was a big deal, too.
Really?
Yeah, they had a band, balloons, the works, you know? He did mention an unusual amount of private military presence.
That's a bingo!
How did the two come together?
Oh, Mr. D, sorry about what happened earlier.
Don't worry about it. I don't trust that kid as far as I can throw him.
Yeah.
So the Festival of Lime...
Oh, yeah, see, they were testing the strength of the new bacteria.
Bacteria. A virus?
Yeah, it's genius. Blue drinks make you sick and red drinks make you better.
I'd hardly call testing bacteria a good folks genius.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. D.
How could they tell which was which?
Well, they served only blue drinks at first, and then they made it rain red drink.
I know this. Red. My sister went to that event. She mentioned the red rain. For some reason, it made her eyes burn.
Well, your sister's lucky. Some people went blind after that.
God.
Yeah.
Not only that, tests got so out of hand, subjects began eating each other.
At the festival?
No! This is after the festival. They released a stronger version and distributed all over town.
The whole town got sick and died.
Yeah. The bacteria they placed in the drink was too powerful and began eating away their immune system.
Seahawk Bay. Joyceville.
Yeah. Everyone dead.
I don't want to talk about this anymore. Where the hell is Dylan?
I don't know. Last I saw him, he was back here.
Yeah, he's been acting very strange.
He's either high or hungover.
No, he better not be Dylan.
There was something that could fuel it up.
I know, but what could it be? Go ahead, answer
it. Go check that out.
All right.
Why, who are you, good sir?
Who is he?
Hey!
Why, funny looking dude.
Okay.
Lost! Do you have directions? I don't know where I am.
Yeah, I can...
My GPS is not working right now. I have no...
Kidding! I am Hawk Juice!
Hawk Juice? Man?
Hawk Juice, man!
Wow!
Yeah! Try our new beverage! Now with less red chemicals!
Oh, yes!
All right! You drink it, because I'm going to take a break.
Delicious!
Nice! Right. Now available in blue and red. Go out there and buy it.
Two colors. And thank you so much for not breaking down our wall. That would be really bad to have to pay for all of that.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You are welcome.
And the hawk juice is good, too.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, are we on?
Good morning, Joyceville, North Carolina.
Is my first or my second or my... I've caught mouth like nobody's business right now. Thank you, Jack.
No, thank you, Sheila, for joining us in such a short notice. My ex-co-host died tragically this morning trying to save a bear from a burning fire.
And we did not trust you to be the show all by yourself, so...
No. I've been training this
since
3.
Oh, well, it's hardly noticeable. Oh, that is quiet. We cannot have nice things. I wish you could see what I'm seeing
right
now.
You're the third person who's told me that today.
Oh, really?
Stop it!
What is this?
I am Nigel Cummings. I'm stuffy and British and constipated, and I've been sent down here by a producer to make you stop everything you're doing right now, especially that. Stop it. I swear, if you do not stop that drug intaking and alcohol drinking business, I will make you eat the whole bottle in one sitting.
I didn't get it.
Whatever.
Protocol must be followed, and I have important news from upstairs.
Ooh, the third floor.
You can't be that serious.
Yes, the third floor.
Maybe it is that serious.
Blind Pork has issued... Code Veronica?
Question for you, Nigel.
Yes, you in front.
What the hell are you doing in my studio?
Our studio.
Sorry, Jack. Yes. Our studio. This is right in the middle of my goddamn show.
Our goddamn show.
I'm sorry, yes. This is our show.
Well,
it is ours. Thank you for
clearly,
me.
One of you two dweebs is in clear violation of Code 7, Section C.
This is a broadcast from the Blind Corporation, ready broadcasting from work.
Hi, you're listening to the Blind Corporation Broadcasting Station, and one thing we want to make sure here at the Blind Corporation Broadcasting Station is that you remember the Blind Corporation Broadcasting Station.
I remember!
Here at the beautiful Blind Corporation Broadcasting Station, we would like to remind you that Hawk Juice is one of our proudest sponsors.
Is it really?
That's right. Hawk Juice, now available with less red chemicals. Have you ever woken up one day and thought to yourself, hey,
no.
I could do a lot less chemicals today, but how about specifically some red ones?
Not
yes,
really,
yes,
no.
yes, if you have asked yourself that question.
A new, refreshing flavor in life. Hawk Juice, now with less red chemicals. Introducing a whole new style of soft drink. With real hawk juice, 10% of your daily red chemicals and only 10 blue chemicals in every 2 1/3 ounces serving. It tastes so good, you can feel it right up in your brain. For great taste, the only style to go is hawk juice.
Here, Rose, we are a family, and that means that whenever you do awesome, great things, I will be your number one fan. But when you fuck up, I am gonna be your biggest critic, because I will always look out for your best interest. And if I say or I do anything that
you know they labeled me blue, Roger.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, they demoted me to clearance level blue.
Oh, but that's such a cool color.
I'm under investigation. I already tried to access my logs, and guess what?
I'll talk to Simmons. Maybe he can do something for you.
What is that Jagoff gonna do for me?
Not you, but maybe Sheila can help.
Oh, the radio junkie.
They are funny, goddammit. And she happens to be a really nice, easygoing, down-to-earth heroin addict. Now, do you know how hard those are to come by?
Oh, I know.
Yeah, they're always like, don't touch my shit. I will stab your knee with an arrow.
That happened to me
once. It doesn't matter, Rose. You can do this. You're gonna go in there and you're gonna give the best fucking speech that you have ever given in your entire life about something that you weren't exactly 100% sure about.
You're right. Okay, you're absolutely right, Roger. Okay, thanks.
Yes, here she is, awesome. Ladies and gentlemen of the awesome Board of Trustees, here is Dr. PhD Rosalind D. Franklin III.
thank you, Dickham.
It's no problem.
Your dick is a...
inappropriate!
A ham. Ladies and gentlemen, Hawk Juice.
Welcome, Private, to the office of Sergeant Richards. Please do state your name and your rank for the record.
Rookie, 2nd Division of 42nd Squad.
Hello, welcome, Private Rookie, and what is the nature of your visit?
I am here to request an audience with Sergeant Richards.
I imagine so. And what is the nature of your visit?
It is a rather sensitive subject that I would rather discuss with Sergeant Richards.
I see. Private, I cannot let you in or even schedule you an appointment with the sergeant without first knowing the nature of your visit.
I am here to quit the Blind Corporation, Private Service.
I imagine so. And what is the reason for this sudden, unpatriotic move?
I believe you have all the information you require thus far. Furthermore, shall only be discussed with Sergeant Richards. Now, when can I see him?
Easy there, snappy turtle. The sergeant is currently busy with another recruit who, well, coincidentally enough, has the same pretentious attitude and unpatriotic desire to leave the good fight.
Well, how long would it be?
Only one way to find out.
How?
You're gonna wait. I'll let the sergeant know of your presence as soon as he is done with his previous engagement.
Thank you, but this cannot wait any longer.
Oh, just take a seat, please. Excuse me, Simon.
What is the nature of this? Receptionist, who is this man?
Sorry, sir. Speedy Gonzales here did not want to wait.
Mr. Gonzales, what is the nature of this nonsense?
Sir, my name is not Speedy Gonzales.
Change, really? Perhaps something to come hungry for taquitos. Someone of your ethnic last name can help me find the best place to satisfy my sudden hunger for carnitas. Wrapped in flour tortillas.
There's a place outside the compound that sells $5 tacos, sir.
$5 tacos? Oh, no. No decent place worth calling themselves the best carnitas wrapped in flour tortillas place will charge only $5 for carnitas wrapped in flour tortillas, sir.
Now, reception. Which I'm sure is your Christian name. Never judge taquito by its price. It is merely a cheap taco.
Sarge, I have news for you, sir. I am a gay.
Really?
Really?
Really.
Really?
Yes, really.
Okay. How did this happen?
If I may be so bold, I would rather have this conversation in private.
Past that point.
Hi. I see. What? But how did this happen?
Sir, I have always been fond of penis. Penis! Ah! Do you like my penis? The Colonel's penis. My penis? I do have a wonderful penis. But in what way is a penis better than a vagina? I don't know, sir. I just fancy penis.
But why?
I just do, sir, okay?
There must be a reason.
Well, there is not. I just fancy penis, and that's that. No reason. I just like penis, no reason why. Maybe it's because I enjoy things that resemble penises. like bananas.
Oh, yes, sir. I'm particularly fond of bananas, hot dogs, baked by hot dogs, corn. Yeah, corn.
Even eclairs.
Sir. Oh, yes, how I crave for that white, delicious, fulfilling.
Pickles.
Oh, man, I love pickles.
But why?
Because they look like green penises.
A reason.
Oh, I guess it's their shape, you know, in a green.
A reason for your gayness.
I have none, sir.
This cannot be. I can tell you why I love vagina. Why can you not tell me why you love penis?
I don't know. I never tried, sir.
Watch. I love vagina. Because even though sometimes it may smell funky, it feels fantastic. I mean, there is nothing, Simmons, nothing in this whole flat world like putting your penis inside my vagina. And so by that reasoning, I cannot fathom the idea of putting my penis inside another penis.
Whoa, that's not how that works.
There can be only one way. Both parties must face each other, eye contact optional. Of course, she's a lady, for God's sake, Simmons. Show some decency.
Sorry, sir. I don't know why I'm apologizing.
You cannot be rude to a lady, rookie. You cannot give her your back when you are entangled in the act of sexual combat.
Sexual combat, sir?
Yes, Private. Do not be fooled by her constant accord and pleas for steady repetition. It is a war, not a race. Do not be fooled twice. Sexual combat is all about the self. The me. Yeah. You enter into it in order to obtain self-satisfaction. If you are doing it for any other reason, you are a godless heathen, a ginger, and a spy for the Communist Party!
I am none of those things, sir!
Then what are you, Brad?
I'm as straight as an arrow!
Fabulous! Nonetheless, I'll eat you up.
Sorry?
Me too. Now, you are here to defect, is that correct?
Yes, sir!
Well, I can't exactly let you do that, but I'll let you try something else instead. Why don't you follow Private Moon back to your unit and introduce yourself to your new commanding officer?
But sir, I really...
Thank you, Private!
Sir, yes, sir!
Fucking rookie.
Ready? Go.
What exactly is Hawk Juice?
What, Jock Juice?
Okay, stop that right now. Ladies and gentlemen of the Blind Corporation Board of Trustees, I present you the very latest in modern biochemical warfare.
Oh, now we're talking!
Meet the new genome capable of bringing the next generation of biochemical weaponry.
This is...
Hydroactive W1D10T Karyotic Joyce. Or, as we commonly refer to it, Hawk Juice. We, as a species, normally carry viral genomes as part of our own genetic material. These can sometimes mutate or assimilate other types of infectious viruses, as you see in these examples. Now, a virus is a very small infectious agent that can replicate only inside the cells of living organisms, and it can infect all types of organisms, animals, plants, or bacteria. Most genomes require the aid of basic chemicals in order to function as living beings. In order to exist, viruses need to extract certain fundamental proteins from a host cell. Now, as they replicate, viruses undergo genetic change through a number of mechanisms. These include a process known as antigenic drift, where an individual base on the RNA or DNA can mutate to another base. Now, most of these so-called point mutations are silent. They don't change the protein that the gene encodes. But others can confer evolutionary advantages such as resistance to antiviral drugs.
Whoa.
Now, what we initially created in our Eastern European juice fill facilities, we were able to further develop in our new laboratories here in beautiful Seahawk Bay.
It's when these facilities officially open their doors.
Oh, for God's sake, who gives a donkey poop? Dr. Franklin, please tell us more about the hawk gyps.
Thank you. Now, viruses use these proteins that they extract from the host cells in order to develop, evolve, or survive. The Cain genome.
That was the NRA strand that you were able to develop in Jewsville.
That's correct.
It has two parts to it, doesn't it?
Actually, there are four variables, which have allowed us to create a very powerful vaccine.
I'm glad to see you're learning to finally cover your ass for once.
Thank you. Members of the board, a simple question to kind of jag on your brains, a kind of brain teaser, if you will. What is the number one thing that there's the most of at the end of any conflict or battle?
Payroll.
Fucking payroll. God, it's like we're huge cock-sucking bastards.
Quiet, Bill, you're being a twat.
No, Bill's right. They're bleeding us dry.
How much is this going to cost us?
Yes, clearly it is about that.
Bill, yeah, you twat. To...
Hey. Now, hang on.
Hey, now all I want to know is... Is this is going to be able to have a tax exemption?
You know, well, I'm sir, getting all kinds of hungry, so while we do this, I think I'm going to call for some carne tabs.
But in order to be recognized as exempt from federal income taxation,
sir,
most organizations are required to apply for exemptions.
Sir.
For Section 501C.
Sir?
A headache.
Yeah, can I get two carne tabs delivered over here so you can see poor favor?
Twat!
I assure you that my finance department has taken meticulous care of this issue several months before approval of the actual facilities.
We want, nay, we need oversight.
Oh, with all due respect,
yeah,
I don't
over
think
here to the third floor of the Blindo Corporation. Oh, muchas gracias, senor, muchas gracias.
Was that Don Pablo's?
Yeah, it was.
I believe we supply meat to them.
Yeah, we do.
You might want to rethink those tacos.
Yeah,
okay.
I
had all of my research pre-approved 19 months before the construction of the facilities, and those took almost a year to build. I am perfectly capable of handling this project without the need for any sort of supervision or oversight.
That was the Sector 4 project, right?
Yeah, that's right. Here in Seahawk Bay.
I got it right here on my screen. About it, and it sounds a lot worse when I talk about
it. It is in Seahawk Bay, Joyceville, North Carolina.
Bill, you fucking twat.
Okay, about the oversight?
Yes. We'll send one of our guys to check up your little setup you have in Sea Bay.
It's Seahawk Bay.
Seahawk Bay.
In North Carolina.
Oh, I know where the fuck it is.
Who are we going to assign?
I don't know.
That guy.
Yeah, why not?
Who, sir?
No, you can't see our monitors, can you?
Yes, it's Jonathan J. Johnson, clearance level red-ish.
Red-ish?
Well, it's more of a pink, really.
Oh, he's in the process of obtaining his red clearance level. So we'll have him do oversight in Sea Bay. That'll do it.
Well, it'll look good on his resume anyway.
Oh, yes, it will.
He fucks up. Won't be a resume to speak of.
Just like this awkward-looking twat right here, Dr. Franklin.
Bill, she can hear you.
Oh, shit.
Sir? Yeah. You're a fucking twat!
That's all, Dr. Franklin!
So why do you got clearance level blue?
Well, the worst part is they're giving us oversight.
You're joking.
No, some jag off from
you. You know? I heard about this guy. He's known as the world. No, God. He was just a huge. Oh, God. He's just a colossal. Oh,
Jesus Christ. What's
what I heard.
The matter with you?
It's fucking disgusting. How many cereal bowls have you had?
I'm trying to
eat. 47. I can't stop. I am so goddamn hungry.
How hungry?
Well, this is all they had left in that kitchen.
But you mean you've already been there?
No. I had all there was left.
Were you in Laboratory 7 today?
No. Why?
Oh.
My daddy does it, you wanna daddy smoke marijuana, daddy's got it tonight. My daddy rolls, don't be hot, daddy rolls, tell me your daddy's got it tonight.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, corporate and celebrities. Who are supposed to be watching this conference from home? We are 7 days shy of officially opening our brand-new facility to the world, and most importantly, this here beautiful town of North Carolina.
Hello, I'm new here. This is the orientation summit? Yeah. Cool. Thanks. Hey, I'm really sorry to bother you guys.
Are you?
Yes. Yes, I am. This is gonna seem like a silly question, but...
Sounds like it so far.
Are there assigned seats or can I just sit anyway?
What the fuck is wrong with you? No, you can't just sit anywhere you please. We have a protocol here.
Oh.
Hey, Nathan! Nathan! Nathan Sanger! Sanger! Nathan! Hey, dumbass. Oh, fuck. Now he turns around. Come here!
Where?
What the fuck do you mean with that? Look with your eyes. Over here. Off into the distance where I still have to shout to talk to you. Come here.
What?
This guy thinks he can sit anywhere he pleases.
Oh my God. Wait, you serious?
Damn straight.
Donkey poopy kid.
Huh.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Good question.
Great question.
Fantastic question.
Who are you?
Yeah.
I'm Jonathan J. Johnson. I'm here to go over the finances for the new facility.
So that's you.
Yeah, that's me.
You're Jonathan from corporate.
Yeah, I would have a name badge. I'd show you, but I'm supposed to get one later on today.
Oh, you want to talk to Phil from accounting.
Well, what about my seat?
No! Hey, how about those Hawk and Tail Vultures winning the polo championship?
Yeah, last night? Go Hawk and Tail Vultures!
Yeah! Go HIV! Go HIV! Woo! Yes!
Okay, let's try one more time.
Woo! That one worked!
Go
oh my
stuff.
Gosh, I don't even want to work.
What? I thought you wanted it. You should be keeping
hey,
it. Keeping
I got a question. Where can I find Phil from accounting?
I never heard of him.
I'm pretty sure he's making him up.
Is that what you're going to be doing around here, Johnny?
Huh?
Hmm? Huh? Making shit up?
Huh?
I'm mainly going to be working with numbers.
Can you believe this motherfucker?
Donkey flipping poop.
But what did I say?
Why don't you go find your seat?
Yeah. It's in the middle of the audience. Section E, seat 12 out of 24. I'm Phil from accounting, by the way.
Whoa! Plot twist!
Mind blown.
Thank you?
Make it the hell out of here!
You know what? This is all for. In case of emergency, and you need to contact our field offices for any reason, the Blindfold Strategy Manual really states except for the fact that due to a print error, the code has been changed. So I will reiterate. Contact field offices with the code Victoria, this is extremely important.
Hey, excuse me. What'd she say? I was trying to find my seat.
Code Veronica, emergency protocol.
Oh, thanks. You never know when that's going to come in handy.
You'll never actually have to use it.
Oh.
Hey, you.
Me?
No, not you. Yeah, you. Come here.
Okay, sure. Hold on a second. Hi. Sorry about that.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
Right, yeah. I'm just trying to get you in the whole
thing.
How's it going?
Sorry.
Hi, I'm Jonathan.
I know. I have been assigned to give you the tour and take you to our registry offices.
So where are those?
You know what? This is ridiculous. Everybody can go. Bring everybody to clear this place up now. Grab a chair and...
Well, I brought everything I'm supposed to have, I believe. I think I have it all in here. Let me look through this thing real quick. I'm pretty sure I have it all. It's, there's my birth certificate right there. It's got everything on it. That's my cover letter with all my recommendations and stuff like that, and my service of employment and all that other stuff. All that good stuff you're going to need. And here, this is a map of Ohio. Dude, those are hard to come by, you know. That's pretty cool and everything. And here's some stuff that I saw last night, but that's not important. Now, here's my test scores. This is my SAT scores, my PSAT scores, my PST, ST plus scores, and here it is. Here's my passport. That's for you, brother. That's my passport. Here's a pizza receipt. Yeah, that's for tax purposes and everything. And, oh, let's see. What else I got in here? I got a gummy bear. That's a lime. But I'm sure you'll like it. There's lime and everything, you know. Those are pretty good and everything. Oh, from me to you, here's a CD, brother. We're going to be working together and everything. I figured, you know, probably.
Am I keeping all this?
Actually, most of those are originals. I'm going to need that back right now. But you can keep the CD, you know, because we're going to be working together and everything.
Okay, thanks.
Actually, you know what? I left my laptop upstairs, and I really like the way this one burns. So I'm going to take that back, but I'll burn you another one, I promise, because, you know, this has got some good stuff on it. Some hip-hop, country, a little bit of heavy metal, and stuff like that.
Stop talking! Welcome to Blind Corps DMV. The acronym DMV isn't the actual acronym for this facility, but it's a joke we have going around. Because essentially, the Department of Identification of All Personnel Employee Registry, or DIPER, it's the same donkey poop.
Oh.
That was inappropriate.
Are you not HR?
Actually, I think that's me.
Really?
That's a load of donkey poop.
Oh.
Anywho, this right here is the end of you. Both of you. All of us. Seriously, fuck this place. However, this is the pivotal place where everything begins and ends. Always. That's the way it was meant to be, and that's the way it will always be. All personnel, and that means all personnel, must report here every day to check in or out of the Blind Corporation.
Everyone has to pass through this place?
Everyone. Comprende, comisionado?
Actually, I only speak French too.
It doesn't matter.
I can kind of count to seven.
Is there anywhere else we need to go on this little tour?
Well, this is it. Have yourselves a wonderful bloody day.
Well, I was hoping you could tell me where that... Can you go and guide me to the thing? I'm supposed to... But I gotta... Over here? Yeah, I'll go over here.
Miss D?
That's Mr. D.
Oh, sorry. Stand over here, please.
Alright, just a moment, please.
Sure thing.
Alrighty, then, you are Mr. Sandra K.D.
Excuse me, it's supposed to be Kenneth D.
You're gonna have to consult
Sandra.
That with HR.
You literally
thank
just
you!
Next... this ID badge.
Thank you!
This is donkey poop.
Yes, sir.
Hi, I'm Jonathan J. Johnson.
Chief Agent is 75%, 85%. Chief Agent complete. Area 60%. Contamination complete. Remain standing till fuck field. Fuck. I just spilled everywhere. God damn it. Don't just stand there like a fucking idiot. Get a paper towel. I know it's hot. What? What are you saying? What? Shut up.
Yeah, this is very close to being hot.
My name is not Mike. The microphone is hot. No, I don't think so. It feels cold, actually. What?
Cheeks, Snickers, and jelly beans, lend me your ears. Though you think you've been petted, don't be silly, forget it. Deb, Flapper, and Baby Vamp, bawl me to tears. What do they know concerning love? Come to me for your burning love. 'Cause I'm the last of the red hot mamas. They've all cooled down but me. Flapper Vamp, say what do they know? Come get your hot stuff from this volcano. I'm an overheater, try and beat it. Hotsy, totsy, hot and tot. Now it may be snowing, but when I get going, oh baby, I'm
hungry. Ma'am!
Oh,
ma'am!
Oh,
you need to come with me, ma'am! You're soaking, you're in danger! You need clearance like team matches! I'm not the doctor, I'm gonna take you to a doctor!
Oh, Dr. Nixon!
Yes,
sir,
ma'am! Dr. Nixon! Yes, you gotta be fine, you're gonna be fine!
Wake up, I haven't got all day.
Give me back my footage. I own the rights to that. They're my rights. I have the rights to
calm down.
Here we go.
Wait, Joe, what the hell's going on? Joe, oh.
Yellow Agent will run off for a few hours. Until then, you'll remain here without leave or explanation because, honestly, anything you hear or say past this point will be absolute nonsense. So, okay, that's that. Lovely. See you in June.
Oh, but it's April.
I know.
Yes, I know.
Indeed, but you're not supposed to know. How much do you know, Rosalind?
I know nothing.
That's what you should know.
No, I don't know anything. What do we call these? Are these hands or elbows? How do I know the names for these things?
Goodbye, folks.
And where is he?
He should be here any minute. Yeah.
Could we go in, please, and go over the plan?
I really would like to wait for Dr. Zeta, because once we start the presentation, I don't want to have to do it twice. And, you know, he really has all the details.
Dr. Leah?
Need about the...
Thank your God, someone competent is here.
Only person that play level eye on are allowed here, so it's, you know...
Hi, I'm Nathan Sanger, coordinator for the Joyce Bills Water Treatment Facilities.
Ah, so you're the monkey in charge. Right, sorry.
Hi, Dr. Sanger. I am Dr. Franklin, and this is Dr. Lin Shaolin.
Where's the shotgun?
Fucking my brother.
Could we go in, Nathan, and go over the plan with Dr. Franklin?
I really think we should wait for Dr.
I'm so sorry.
I'm so late.
I'm sorry.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, my God.
Sorry.
Dr.
Oh, my God.
Doctor.
Doctor.
Doctor. Kate. All right, you awkward-looking twat. Welcome to the Joyce Mills Water Treatment Facility.
I love this guy.
You know what? I find it absolutely ridiculous.
What?
So get this. I go to pick Susie up from daycare.
Ah, your daughter.
Yes. Rude. Wow. I go pick her up from Quayside.
Ah, that's the daycare.
Yes. Please, stop stating things as if they were facts for a sort of audience looking to make a connection. Now, the whole reason Gene and I pay for that place is...
And Gene is your husband.
What?
Wife. No! Fuck!
What? Can I tell the story?
Shut the fuck up, Kate!
Yeah, the whole reason Gene and I pay almost $300 for 3 days a week and 5 hours a day for that totally out of the way, by the way, children's prison is because that little shit has way too much energy. So, you know, we take her there. She can, like, run around and wear herself out and just break shit that isn't ours.
If your people wouldn't mind putting these on.
I might. I'm allergic to, like, almost anything, so...
Could you be any more annoying?
I could sing you a song out of tune.
Oh, of course you can.
Would you stand up and walk out on me?
Stop.
This is for your own safety. Now, we'll be walking around Sector 12, Area Terminal E. And that portion of the facility is still under treatment for the test following the new strand of hydroactive W1D10T karyotic joints.
Okay, I am going to need something to write with.
Oh, well, you can use your phones while using our state-of-the-art touch-sensitive gloves. We made them so we could still use our blind core issue phones.
Yeah, well, so then I get there and guess what?
What?
Naps? They have fucking nap time.
Donkey.
Wait, hold on.
What?
You pay money so they can provide a place for your daughter to nap?
I know, it's absolutely ridiculous.
She's probably really well rested.
I know, Rose. God.
And about you and Gene.
Shut the hell up, Kate. We're in the middle of a very serious meeting. Now, what's about to happen here will transpire to the pages of history as the biblical moment in which mankind stopped walking and took a giant...
A massive.
Huge.
China big.
Yeah, pretty oversized leap into the new phase of the world. History. World history. We're making world history.
And that little shit has way too much energy.
You're paying almost $300 for your daughter's naps.
I will end all of you.
Welcome to Sector 12.
What's that?
I said you want some more.
Cocaine? You have cocaine?
Oh, but I got a dick. You got a pretty face.
What the fuck is going on here?
I fucked up!
Yes, you did!
I'm sorry, sir!
You know what? I am fed up with your shenanigans.
I said I'm
not. Don't give a donkey poop what you said, say, or going to say. You were so terminated. Fired. GTHO.
But my performance review, sir.
Here it is. You are so fired. You stupid twat, sign me.
That's not a performance review at all. It's more like a statement about my current employment.
That's exactly. That's kind of what that is.
Big words, huh?
All right, here it is. You are no longer working for this establishment.
Yeah, that's the same thing, except different.
Oh, you want a review?
That's what I've been asking.
Shut
for.
Up! Rhetorical question. Okay, here it is. Currently unemployed!
Stay out of it, Rose.
Shut the fuck up, Kate!
Are you?
Thank you! Mm-hmm. Leave now. Leave now. Leave now, now, leave!
Oh, listen here!
Why aren't you leaving?
I'm a valuable asset to this company! Without me, this entire fucking sector will be nothing but a gigantic biohazard wasteland! Get over there as an incompetent monkey!
Wait, one second! Picture me!
Oh, wait! That's too offensive to monkeys! It would also imply the learning curve and the further possibility of growth. No! She's about as usable as a used tampon classmate!
That is gross!
He's shouting over there!
Fuck off, nerd!
You're the biggest fuck up of the entire system!
You watch your words, rookie! You're threatening the mighty
You neutralized the evil agent!
Come here, and now the fucking chemical! What's your
You're gonna give me a speech about how you're gonna make sure no one ever hires you ever again?
Whoever is stupid enough to hire you deserves to deal with all your stupid bullshit.
Yes!
Ha! There's your performance review! And if you don't leave, I'll be obligated to remove you by force from the premises.
Kick his ass!
Fools! You should yet be sorry, each and every one of you! My revenge has just begun! Neocorp was right about you!
Okay, enough! Eat donkey shit, Ruby!
Annoying little fuck! Roger, as much as I love that, don't do it again.
I thought it was great.
Check it out, guys! My gloves, and I can still use my phone.
He's unnecessarily proud of such a small achievement.
I can scroll through my menu.
Did I get an email?
Can I check it out? Why, yes, I can. Couldn't have done that before, probably, but never quite so efficiently. I mean, look at this. Oh, email? Here I come. Swoop, swoop, swoop. Boom! This new type of technology really is.
What is it?
Nathan! Sector 12!
Stop! Everyone, please start calmly making your way out of the facilities.
What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. Nothing's wrong. Nothing is wrong. Nothing. Nothing at all is wrong at all.
There's not a break in protocol in Sector 12.
That's here!
Yeah, the X-15 CT is disrupted and concentrated in bioengine Unit 5 and Unit 7. All personnel must immediately evacuate and execute extreme caution. Nerve agent Adam potential outbreak.
Outbreak! No time. Load up command screen. Type in MS Config.
Roger!
What? Type in and enable all Windows essential files.
Roger!
What?
The doors have been sealed shut!
Why?
To prevent the agent from escaping! But there's another way to open another exit!
Are you going to restart the system?
No! Control up the leak!
What the fuck is happening?
I didn't help!
I got an email!
Is it from HQ?
Yeah, I got that same email too!
And did I!
Ginny was mutated and now all of Sectors 18 through 5 have been placed under quarantine.
What does that mean?
We're all infected!
Eva's gone airborne!
Who's the resistance gene? Adam and Kate should counter the viral growth!
Yeah, that was a theory that everyone would pan down!
Shut the hell up, Kate!
We are all dead! We should have quit! We're all dead!
Thank you.
the anticipator in HQ.
Lieutenant Miller, this is HQ.
Lieutenant Miller, we read you loud and clear.
Field operations have reported sightings of the infected in your area.
What does that mean?
There have been reports of massive amounts of the infected in or about your general location, sir.
Negative, HQ, no signs of infected.
Are you sure, Lieutenant?
I don't see anything. Pretty damn sure, HQ.
We believe you are walking into what could basically be described as a huge zombie orgy, sir.
Sorry, HQ, it ain't so. No orgies, no sexy dead-eye orgies going on. Or are they?
No,
they are not.
Exercise extreme caution. We have been issued code Veronica.
Roger that!
That doesn't sound right.
I have no clue what that means.
Shit just got real, Lieutenant.
Okay, who is this?
I'm a friend, Lieutenant.
Where are you?
A friend of Kenneth's.
Really not what I asked.
Well, maybe I heard you and I didn't want to answer.
How do you know, Casey? Who are you?
A friend, Lieutenant.
Look at this dump.
No sign of survivors.
Damn.
Bojango, how about you move ahead?
Which one is Alpha? Which one is Bravo?
I don't know, Rick. You kind of just go with the flow around here.
Yeah, it's when everyone's closer to Lou. Usually just goes ahead and moves whatever direction he's pointing.
Oh, Lou?
Yeah, Lieutenant Miller. We call him Lou. Not around camp, of course, sir.
No, they chew us up.
But when we're on the field, Lieutenant likes us to know that we are brothers and our lives are all worth the same. That's legit.
Yeah, get over here. Now, I've been in this company a long time, Rookie, and we don't just consider ourselves a group of brave soldiers facing impossible odds. Ain't that right, you two?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We consider ourselves a family.
So that's amazing.
I'm talking. So if you want to be part of the best of the best, you go out and scout for infected or survivors.
Sir, yes, sir. I'm glad to be part of something, sir.
Proud of you, soldier. Rookies.
I know. I can't believe he bought that crap.
I know, right?
Oh my god!
Shut up! I like you.
Sir.
Ah! Oh, crap!
What was that?
Hey, I'm a man from sale.
What was that?
I want to shoot something too.
Oh god, where is it?
Move, don't let it get away.
Let me just see it.
No, you don't lie.
Fine, I don't see it.
Is everyone okay?
No.
Is everyone important okay?
Oh, yes, I'm
okay, let's go, let's go.
Wait! I think I got it. They are everywhere! Lieutenant?
They got us surrounded!
No! Don't do anything.
Everybody calm down.
Be back at me.
They got some ugly ones over here.
Not on this time, you heard me. I mean, oh my god, there's more over here!
Everybody back!
Don't make any rational moves.
Rational?
Yes, the lessons made. At least make my marriage with you.
I'm pretty sure you made them.
Thanks for unnecessarily. How long did that take you?
About an hour or so.
To make an X with two wooden planks?
What do I know? I'm just a man with hammer and nails.
Right.
You got something else for me to do?
You ever shot one of these before?
Yeah, I'm quite familiar with that there, weapon.
You're useless to me, kid.
Well, I could try.
We don't have the ammo for target practice.
Well, there must be something else I could do.
Yes, you can stay the hell out of the way.
God, look at them all.
And they're all just staring this way.
It's like they're watching us.
Yeah, it's as if we were actors in a play performing for them.
Who'd want to see us?
They would.
Mother of God, not creatures! Maybe he's getting something to eat.
Not funny!
Too soon?
What do you think it's like?
To what? Be a zombie?
Yeah.
Well, I suppose it's kind of like being an anorexic baby with ADD.
What do you mean?
Well, for starters, they're always hungry. And they struggle with their extremities, and they react weird to flashing lights and loud noises. They're always drooling.
I can appreciate that because you just hurt me. Thousands of other babies around the world are struggling with anorexia and ADD.
Are you serious? Why would you think that's okay to share? I didn't mean it like that. I'm sorry.
Real smooth, Lady Killer.
How's she doing?
Oh, he's doing terrible. I doubt he'll ever get laid with that game.
Not that jackass. That jackass. She had the master sword and everything. How's she doing?
I doubt she'll live.
Hey.
That bad, eh?
Yeah, in fact, it's nothing short of a miracle that she's made it this far.
Hey.
Oh, shut up. You're dying.
What about you?
Oh, I'll be all right as long as I have my no-no juice.
What do you make of the gunfire?
No clue. But isn't it funny we decided to acknowledge it just now?
I hope that whoever it is are coming to rescue us.
What was that noise?
Everybody stay calm. Probably nothing, but take cover just in case.
Well, what if they're mercenaries? I'll take them out.
Oh, okay. Whatever. Yeah,
all right. Okay, this gives me no joy.
Well, ask first and then shoot after. Got it?
Wait. Shoot? What if they shoot back? I could get killed.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
That's a distinct possibility.
Okay.
Crap! What the hell was that?
Stop, please, we're survivors!
You stop, Jesus, man! You killed one of my men!
I ain't dead, Lou!
Shaw, you ain't dead?
No, I'm not dead!
Good man, Shaw! I knew you had it in you!
You thought I was dead?
Okay, I kind of thought you had it in you!
Donkey poo! Seriously, donkey poo! Who talks like that? I've never heard that before!
Mister, how many people you got there?
There were 5 of us!
Okay, let's keep it that way! Shaw, we'll be right there with you to patch you up! Ain't that right, mister?
Thanks, Lou!
Yeah, that's right!
Alright! I'm glad we came up to an agreement. Now, I'm gonna send in another one of my company men. Don't go around shooting this one.
Okay.
Move in.
Why me? I can't help him.
Shut up, Moody. Go patch up Private Shaw.
Sir.
Ma'am, are you all right? Ma'am.
Oh, my God.
What the fuck was that?
It was Bill Lightress number 2.
Moon.
Sorry, sir. I got anxious.
Oh,
well, that just takes the cake. Okay, mister. All good. Just a tactical mishap.
Tactical mishap? How many of you bastards are out there?
Easy now. There's only 4 of us. And we mean you no harm. We are here to help.
You've killed 2 of us.
Now. We are here to help. No more trigger-happy business. Now, can we come in?
Oh, well, why don't you just barge on in, you savages?
Well, that just tills my pickle. I don't reckon it right to just wander in without a proper invitation.
Who the fuck
of
are
Of course, a shotgun to the face ain't much of a great hospitality, so you understand my invitation.
Wake up, kid, you're embarrassing yourself.
Bubble tushy?
Shut up, I ain't your bubble tushy. I do indeed understand. All right, I'm letting him in.
Shirley, you can't be serious.
I am serious, and don't you dare call me Shirley. Now, peel eyes at the first sign of... No, no, you don't, you little fruit. I need you awake.
Okay,
get up.
Okay, I'm fine.
Okay. You can come in now.
Lieutenant Miller here at your service, Mr.
Jackie?
Kenneth?
Holy shit, it really is you.
Well, yeah.
You know what?
You!
Me?
She's our optional objective, sir.
Well, aren't you fucking popular?
Susan Boyle, sir.
Really?
How'd you get my name?
Cause you are in big trouble, Miss Boyle.
Hey, wait a minute, what's going on here?
Oh, well, Miss Boyle over here is possibly the reason why this whole end of the world scenario is playing out.
No! I could have stopped it, but the drooling idiot in charge of the East End of the virus, Go Ryan Mutate.
And who might that be?
Kevin Malone. But that's a huge load of donkey poo.
Guys, I don't need to be a pain in the ass or anything.
I'm bleeding death over here.
I thought that you patched him up.
What the hell do I know about medical assistance?
Well, what did he do?
Just sort of.
Damn it, Moon, patch him up.
Ow. Whatever you say, boss.
Oh, Miss Boyle, you are coming with us.
No way, I won't stand for that. I'm already paying me for all of this.
Time to own up, Miss Lady. Take some responsibility for your actions!
Yeah, that's what mature adults do.
No way, rotten scum! I'm not going without any damn dirty apes to lay upon me!
Do apes have paws, you guys?
Is this true?
I believe they do have paws, or is it hat?
Not that! The fact that you almost doomed us all!
Oh, yeah, that. No. Maybe. Let me explain.
Yeah, I'd love to hear that one. Lou, we found it!
Two for one! Booyah!
Is that the ticker?
Almost all of it, sir!
Where are the rest of the boxes?
In the back, why?
Because we got a pretty prize hidden inside every box, Mr. Sir!
Get the boxes and begin assembling it!
Well, assembling what? What is that, a bomb?
You and your annoying questions.
Well, answer me, damn it!
John, you were really helpful on the radio, by the way.
How'd you know it was me?
By your annoying accent.
Well, how you know my name?
Yeah, his accent is annoying!
Well, what we got ourselves here is a little nuclear warhead.
You're gonna blow up the town?
Oh, nah. You see, we ain't into blowing up business.
What the fuck is he doing?
We are in the remodeling at grandiose scale business and, whew, we got ourselves a job to do.
You like that stuff.
Yeah, it's good for me.
Give me one of them, please.
How can it be good for you? That stuff caused all this.
Actually, that ain't quite true.
What?
John, you didn't tell him? Johnny. Oh, what your boy over here didn't tell you is that when Blanco moved their testing facilities to Seahawk Bay, they didn't exactly do it for that beautiful countryside and those wonderful sandy beaches.
They did it for the water treatment facilities. It was the fastest way to distribute 1.8 million test samples of a brand new virus to an unknowing, naive community.
They infected us.
That's a bingo.
Unfortunately, as you may all know, it got a little out of hand. The virus mutated.
Made the population very sick. We needed more time, more tests.
And then they came up with this brilliant idea to put up a fair. Come try our brand new beverages, they said.
The flavor of that.
Yep, that's what they called it.
We served the vaccine in its original form as a blue drink, but as the day progressed, we noticed our test subjects weren't reacting to the vaccine.
That's why they made it rain red chemicals.
Our failsafe, if you may.
That's why the rain burned my sister's eyes. It was a vaccine.
She was there? Did you hear? Some people went blind.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Well, that proved not to work either, so we began distributing a more powerful strain of the vaccine.
Hot juice!
Hot juice is the vaccine. But it says it's beer and soda pop!
Hey, we couldn't just bluntly tell everyone that they were infected with the rare manufactured virus. I mean, could you imagine the types of public outcry?
They sold it to us as beer and soda pop!
Might as well make a few bucks out of it, huh?
Whole town of fucking guineas!
We tried to help, we had no idea we were gonna get this out of hand.
Yeah, save your sorries for the jury. Private Utah, we have a town to blow up.
I'm working on it, sir!
Right on.
You can't blow up the town, there may be other survivors.
Doubt it. We've been walking a pretty perimeter, and you are the only ones who are trying to eat us.
Can't be true.
Sorry it ain't up for discussion. Private Moon, apprehend Miss Boyle and secure the perimeter.
Right away, sir. Sir, what do we do about the bodies?
I get these people to serve a purpose. Move them out back.
Yes. You heard the man.
Show me the back.
Okay, let's go.
All right. 10, 40.
Yeah, this is happening.
Okay. Yeah. Drop your wounds.
Yeah, we're good. This is happening.
Carry
dead body.
Yep. Dead body
moving. How you doing there, buddy?
I've been better.
Bet you wish they shot Utah instead, huh?
Hey, I am right here, you guys.
Shut up. No one likes you.
What? That's not true!
Yeah, it is. Am I right, Shaw?
It's true, Utah. Nobody likes you.
Are you guys serious right now?
Yeah. Sorry, you're a douchebag. No,
Jesus.
Sorry. Karma's a bitch. Ain't it?
What? What do you mean?
Would you say Rookie was killed by zombies or friendly fire?
Zombies, you all saw it.
It was pretty dark, but I do recall seeing both of you shooting Rookie like a couple of frightened jackasses.
See, no.
Yeah, you killed Jake.
That wasn't Rookie's name.
I know. It's the name I gave him. He was my Jake.
You were banging the Rookie?
No. But he was the only one who wasn't thinking with his dick. He respected me. He spoke softly to me. He always looked up to me.
He did.
And you killed him.
I did indeed.
When I was in Seahawk Bay, I saw a lot of my friends and family die because of what this company did to my town. I'm from Joyceville, and I witnessed Blindcore turn my town into a zombie infested town, and I burned it to the ground!
Why are you telling me
this? Ain't gonna lie to you, Shaw. I lost it there. Now life seems like blurred flashes of moments that never seem to stick around. Like waves of an acid frenzy. No longer distinguish between what's real and what's made up.
What do you mean?
Sometimes I think I died in Joyceville. With all my friends and family. You know what? That thought doesn't scare me as much as it used to. In fact, it brings this warm kind of nostalgia that I love to dip into every once in a while. Until I met Jake, that is.
I see. By the way, Moon, you're creeping me the
Jake
fuck out right now.
Gave me that same feeling. That the morbid connotations thinking about Joyceville gave me. Having that kid around was a blessing. I began to feel like maybe not dying in Joyceville was a good thing. I survived for a bigger purpose. And that kid was gonna show me the way.
Why are you telling me?
Because I'm going to kill you.
Rather you didn't.
Shh.
Get that fucking gun out of my face, Moon.
What did you just do?
Daddy don't need to know what little sister's doing.
You're fucked up.
Shut up. And you. You. I have no idea how happy I am I found you.
What do you mean?
I think the most suitable way for you to go home is for you to witness firsthand what you caused with your little chemical.
Jesus, tap down to Fernando Christ, what is going on? This bad woman just killed the only person that could possibly make the vaccine!
She had it coming!
What did you do? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you the first time. You kind of mumble when you talk.
She took Susan out there, now she's being eaten alive by those abominations! Not to mention she killed that guy?
That guy?
He's not dead. He's sleeping.
I don't tolerate insubordination in my troops.
Fuck, man! I don't think I can handle this shit anymore!
Calm down, kid.
Shut the fuck up! You mean fucking bitch! You've been telling me to be a fucking bitch since the minute I walked in here! You think you know me, motherfucker? You don't know me! Who do you think you are? Shut the fuck up! You mean, stupid motherfucker! How do you know I want to cut you right now? I will cut your head off, and I will sit down your motherfucking neck! Because you are mean, fucking, arrogant little punk-ass bitch! And you!
thank you.
I know.
Oh my god. Oh my god, thank you.
I know. I think it was his face.
Oh god, it was. It was just something about it.
You just wanted to punch it out.
Literally from the moment he walked in.
How did you do?
Lots of drinking.
I understand.
So much.
Sir! The bomb is armed and ready.
Excellent.
Except.
Expect.
That's not what I said, but okay. So the LCD screen got dropped, and there's no way to manually activate the bomb.
Excuse me?
But, well, luckily we found this handy little device that will let us detonate it remotely.
Huh. Ain't that lucky? So, just press this button?
Yes, sir.
Nothing else?
No, sir.
No extra numbers, codes, buttons, wires, anything?
Nope, just even that red button, sir.
Absolutely.
Feel nothing about his death.
As you should, nobody liked that kid.
You can't do this. I won't let you do this, Jack.
Too late, I already shot him. The bomb is armed and this is the only way to make it go.
That's not what I was talking about, but I won't let you.
Again, he is pretty goddamn dead. You don't get any dead.
I'm serious, Jack.
It's Lieutenant Miller! This is nothing but a zombie-infested town, and this is the only way to cleanse.
But it's my town, and I will be damned if I let you blow it up!
Now, CQ, back the fuck up and chill for a moment!
Don't tell me to calm down! You don't get it! This is my town, and I can't just sit there and let you reduce it to ashes!
Like you did to me.
You melodramatic.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Now!
You do not know how hard it was to let you go! I mean, the years I spent—
Okay, shut up, okay? I get it.
No, wait, I had a whole speech prepared.
Oh, I know. Trust me, I know.
I never loved you. I diluted myself into thinking that I did.
Well, I'm genuinely sorry to hear that.
No, you're not. And that's what kills me, the fact you didn't even feel like that. It was just me. And you acted as if everything we had never even happened.
At first, yes, I did. I was young. I was stupid. But you're wrong. I did miss you. And after a while, I realized what I did to you was wrong. But what do you want? What do you want, Jackie? Do you want me to formally apologize for the way that I behaved towards you? Fine, here it is. I'm sorry. I was such a bitch to you before we broke up.
I broke up with you.
Okay, you see, that is irrelevant. You focus so much on the things that don't matter and you completely overlook the things that do.
Are you saying that I'm like that?
No. My bad. That was more of a self-realizing. The point is, I have to start over again. Completely from zero. And I'm sorry, but I also knew there was no way to fix our relationship. And honestly, we were two different people. We had two different lives. You joined Blind Corps, and I ruined every chance that I had for a great future. I failed out of my school. I disappointed my family. And I never had friends I could call friends. Like I knew people, but they weren't friends.
You're one sad story, man.
Yeah, but this town gave me the chance to turn that around. A chance for redemption. Now, I worked hard, and I applied myself as much as I could. You know what? In time, I had my own place. In time, I had enough money to join the Blind Corps Partnership Program and start a diner.
I forgot all about—
No, that's not what I said!
Yeah, it is! Just another mistake, another bump in the road, huh?
No! It wasn't like that!
Well, it doesn't matter much now, does it? I'm sorry you feel this way, but this town has got to go.
I can't let you do that!
Is that Moon's gun?
Yeah. Picked it up from her after you shot her.
Good luck firing that weapon.
I know my way around guns.
Not that one. You see, I designed it especially for me. The recoil will jerk you like a fucking donkey. The aim is crooked and it'll be nothing short of a miracle if you barely graze me with a bullet. The gun is basically useless. Unless, of course, you're a Private Moon.
Oh, Moon, eh?
She was too exposed to the red chemicals and went all cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
Is that what happened?
Allegedly. She was the only survivor from the Seahawks.
Shut up! I've heard enough! I'm not gonna let you do this, Jackie! This is not gonna be another Seahawk bait!
My organs! I was in love with you, you fucking idiot.
I know!
Time to face the music.
Weapon activated. Cold stone. Tin. tracking system remotely deactivated.
Donkey poop!
Successfully disarmed.
Helena